Alright guys, so I want you to ignore everything around you. That will all be shown to you in a soon video, or maybe before this one. I don't know, shut up. We're going to be doing a tutorial on this building here. It is, I'd say, medium difficulty. It's really not a hard build to do, but as soon as you've kind of learnt the steps, and you can see it here underneath, this particular one isn't being used for anything special. As you can see, there's nothing on the inside, but you can see that you can make a perfectly good house out of it. So without further ado, let's go. So I'm going to be building it in the middle of this ice just because I don't know where else to put it. Obviously I'll be moving it somewhere better later, but let's just take a look at the materials we're going to be using a lot. We're going to be using some spruce wood stairs, spruce wood planks. We're going to be taking some oak wood, and obviously this is using the conquest texture pack. You don't have to use the conquest texture pack, but if you do, then you get some this block here, which I'm going to grab and put into my inventory. Where is it? There it is. We're also going to need cobblestone for the roof, so that's full slabs and planks. I don't think we're going to need any stairs. Let's just move all this over to one side. We're also going to need some spruce wood slabs to go with our other bits, and some normal oak wood, and our main building material, which is going to be spruce wood. So let's start off by marking out our kind of area. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3 block, 1, 2, 3 block. This is the completely normal generic shape house that I do like all the time. So it's just going to be, it's actually a square base. And then we're going to go up twice with our wooden barrels. And then we're just going to go around and give it all feet. When our building is nicely footed, then we're going to do the same to the top half. I'm just going to go around doing it the quickest way. I think this is the quickest way anyway. But you first do that, then you go around doing all the insides. And then reverse and do it back to front. Oh, maybe that wasn't the quickest way, but it shouldn't take you long anyway. Now we need to decide which side's going to be our front. I'm going to use this as my front, so I'm going to start off on the side, and I'm going to place 4 of these going up. In fact, I'm going to do that on every pillar, because every pillar is going to need these. When you have that, you can go ahead and block off these gaps with a sideways plank, and then come to the top of a pillar and place blocks like this, so they are every other. That made sense, didn't it? Sure. Now we have our end, and we know where our crossbeam is going to go. It's going to stick out one block like that, and we can make this look nicer by making this go sideways like that. And then I like to do every other block, so I'm going to go ahead and do this. Actually, I'll leave it that there. So again, that's crossing it off, and then flipping around some of these logs. So now we're going to make the roof shape. So I'm just going to go up from this block here, and then I'm going to go up once more. So that's 2 up, and then 2 sets of 2 blocks up, and then the middle piece. That didn't really make much sense, but you can work it out from what I've done there. So once again, that's 2 small ones, 2 1 blocks, and then 2 blocks, and then the center. For this particular design, I like to bring up a crossbeam here as well. Now I'm going to use a bit of world edit here, but it's not really a huge amount. What I'm going to do is copy this whole end piece here. I'm just going to expand this selection up by 30, and then I'm going to copy and paste it right next to each other. I'm also going to remove these blocks here though, because we don't want them. So we're going to make this 2 blocks thick. I'm also going to paste it dead in the middle. Okay, again, removing these blocks, we don't want them. And then the same at this end, so right here. So in a kind of not block for block tutorial way, I'll explain why we did that. Main reason is it means that we can have an indented wall here, so I'm going to go ahead and fill that in. This just makes it look a lot more chunky and a bit more Nordic, like that. You can choose to bring this bit out if you prefer. I'm going to leave it in. And then obviously your windows will go in kind of here. You can make them that shape or that shape. I quite like that shape, and then filling it in with something like fences. But we'll just leave it for like that for now. The other side effect of doing this double thickness at the end is that we still end up with our blocks of 3, our gaps of 3 in between all the roof supports. I'm going to place the barrels in these little gaps here. I perhaps should have just left them from when I copied, but meh, like that. And then on top of the center one, we're going to have another piece of log. So the most distinctive feature about this build is the arched roof. So we're going to make that by raising this all by one block, this center piece. And you can also remove the bits on the underside, and I don't like this here either. Let's just clear that all away. And now we can start on the roof. So our spruce wood planks are going to be the trim, so we're going to add these onto the end. And for now, I'm just going to drag them all the way across. Now, the way we're going to do this is we're going to have a group of 3 here, and then it's going to raise up 1, 2, 3, and then it's going to go to another 4 blocks. So we can remove these 3 blocks here. And this is pretty much what you're going to be doing throughout the whole roof, so I'm just going to do it with cobblestone. So obviously I'm leaving the end ones, but if I fill up this side of the roof here like that, and then I do up the middle, then we know exactly where our half blocks are going to go. So the way I do the half blocks is I bring them out like this, so from the top of the ones on the side, oops, and then an extra one on top to fill up the gaps. Now obviously when you get to these bits that are two blocks thick on the roof, you're going to end up with some nice big gaps. Well, I don't know what I'm saying, not nice big gaps, which you're going to have to fill in by hand, which is not so fun, but at least it means that the inside of the roof is going to be as tight as possible, so you're not going to have any wastage on the roof. But there we go, this might take a while. Now our ends are really simple, we're just going to plop them all the way along the side. There we go. And now we can work on the top ridge. So the top ridge is exactly the same, we're just going to have one block above. So for example, this is one block now, that's one block there, and then we just need to do the slabs to make it one block in the middle. I also like to make the very top just a little bit higher, so I'm just going to add three there to make it a bit more shapely. And then we can do our sexy dragon head. So the way I do the dragon heads is I place upside down stair there, and two on top, and then one underneath. Remove them and also remove this one. So that's going to be a little beard of our dragon. And I'm going to place a half block on top, a full block behind the half block. And then we're going to need two upside down stairs above this, so one facing that way and one facing that way. There's the mouth of our dragon. I'm going to place a full block there just to help me place the eye, which is an upside down stair, and then remove the full block and replace it with a half block. And then behind the eye, we're just going to place an upside down one, a right way up one. And then we're going to have a full block, a half slab, and a full block, and that will bleed nicely into the rest of the roof. So there's our dragon. Now for this particular build, I'd recommend dropping it down. So maybe, well, just make it the right size to begin with would probably help. But I'm just going to do this with the world of it. There we go. And that just kind of flows nicer with the roof, it doesn't look as weird. So now we have one half of the roof done, we can copy this because obviously this build is symmetrical. So I'm going to go from this corner here right up to this corner here. I'm going to stand right in the middle, I'm going to copy it, rotate it by 180 degrees, rotate, there we go, and paste it, and hopefully, there we go, we have head at each end, which is wrong. What the hell? I've just been staring at this trying to work out why it went wrong. It's just because I cut off a bit of the ears and then this bit coming down here. There we go. Oh wait, no, that's supposed to be filled up, isn't it? There we go. That confused the hell out of me. So let's come to the inside, and we're going to block off all of these little holes here, and then we're going to take our normal oak wood planks, there we go, and fill it in. Now I like to use just the right amount so that I've got kind of gaps. It just makes the thing look a bit bigger. Let me show you what I mean. Instead of filling it up like this, I prefer filling it up just like this, so we've got a nice big hole there. Completely unnecessary, but kind of cool. And now I'm going to bring these beams down so they don't look so silly. Now the interior is a little bit awkward, it's not a particularly nice interior, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my spruce wood stairs, I'm just going to lay these all across like this. Some of these will be replacing with half slabs, but for now they can just go like that. And that's pretty much upstairs done, you can do whatever you like with this. You could actually have room to fit another room up here, although it won't be very big, but it would definitely be big enough to walk around, but I'm not going to do that for this build. Oops. Now downstairs you can make everything look a little bit nicer by making everything slope up to this point. So what I mean by that is doing this, so that's like, yeah, so the best way of doing it I think is like this. So the way I do that is make an L shape and then make a smaller L shape one layer up, so that's an L shape and then a smaller L shape, and there you go, there you have that. That's pretty much it, but there are some more details that make I think make it look a little bit nicer. At these end pieces here I like to do that, I don't know why, I just do. You could also do it that way up to make it look a little bit more curved, or you could just, oopsie, you could just go for the two upside down like that to make it look more arched. All in all, there's a huge amount you could do to this build to make it just a bit more unique. This is a very generic style which you can apply to everything, which is why I like it so much. Like, just closing off that instantly makes this feel a bit more like a room. You could, of course, completely close this off with cobblestone and turn inside into an actual room, and the way you're going to want to do that is when you've great tutorial there, James, brilliant. Like that, and then it makes these bits square. So I'll do that one more time because this is probably what quite a lot of people are going to want to do with it, because they want the downstairs as well. So again, that's filling it up, make these two bits square, and then disguise it with that. There we go. So there you go, thanks for watching guys. I know this build is quite lame compared to the stuff behind me, but this is a very good starting point, and if you master this style then you can apply it to everything. You can increase these gaps here to 5 block gaps. You can obviously add another 3 block section on the end here, and everything will just kind of flow together and look sexier. So don't forget to leave a rating if you enjoyed the video, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys next time.